don't change anything. Carry on what you are doing, just keep on adding. Now, please understand, we need you for a reason. Herbalife in India has been 21 years and we will continue to grow and expand. Andhra Pradesh is doing extremely well. You have India's first chairman club from Hyderabad. We have so many president teams under Rajuji itself. So you are a part of the organization that is simply blessed. I just want to spend 1 minute and tell you why you are so important. You see, please understand, India is a country of now close to 150 crore people. 150 crore people need better nutrition. 3 times a day, twice a day, once a day, but every day. If you look at the projection, we will cross China next year. We will be the world's largest country. And the best part about this country is we are a democracy where people have choices. They are not forced to do what other countries are forcing them to do. So most of you will see India be 150 crore population by the end of this decade, but the way things are going will be there faster. You look at Andhra Pradesh, for example, the state that you belong to, or Telangana as it is called now. You have so many districts, so many people with so much population. Today, you are 4 crore in Telangana. Hyderabad is over 1 crore itself in the cities. It's among the top cities in the country. And we need you people to get this message across. But important thing is most of us, and when I started, I was also a part of this, we didn't know why we are doing Herbalife. So today I want to teach you briefly about goal setting. I
know meeku ee brief ga ee roju nen goal setting gurinchi maatladtanu.
Talk about goal setting before we go into the business in future trainings, because if you don't understand what you are doing, then you cannot do much. So one of my favorite business philosophers is Friedrich Nietzsche. She said, he who has a why can bear anything as long as you know what you are doing. Today we will talk about goal settings in the next half an hour. This is a time to take notes. And I can tell you that in the next 10 weeks we have together, most of the trainings are going to be information and knowledge and skill development. We are not going to talk about hype. We are not going to create that you are important. It is unbelievable. So please take notes. And if you don't understand what I tell you today, understand that when you read the notes again, you will understand. And one fine day, you will be trainers yourself. Goals have to be smart. And I will repeat this again, but just write down, if you are going to be doing goal setting today for yourself and your family and your organization, make them specific, measurable, achievable, realistic, and time-bound. This is called smart goals. And I will talk about this subsequently. Now, you will hear many trainings on goal setting, but I wanted to give you a different aspect of why people set goals. Why would you want to set goals? So you can set goals based on the limitations you have faced or are facing. You can set a goal because you want to be a what's called a revenge goal, or you can set a goal because you're aspirational for growth. And I will explain this briefly. Limitation goals are goals that are based on your past experience, but you carry on applying them today. For example, if many of you cannot speak English, or you will say, oh, I have never done well in an environment where English speaking is important. So I cannot do this business because most trainings, most meetings, most people we know want English speaking people. But that is not true. So don't limit yourself to your handicap. What you don't have, you don't have. Focus on what you have. This is a limitation goal. And it is not desirable to set goals by limiting yourself. Sadhguru, one of the most well-known South Indian again person, says, once you let your past decide your present, you will destroy your future. Am I audible? Okay. So don't let your past damage your future. Your future is unseen. You know what happened in the past, but you cannot change it. You
sir,
don't.
Telugu.
Yes.
Telugu.
Hello.
Telugu lo translation nastundi. Telugu lo meeru okasari andaru kuda kinda manaki
సెట్టింగ్ మన లోపల ఉంటుంది అనమాట. మనకి మోర్ లో మీరు చూడండి ఒకసారి, ట్రాన్స్లేషన్ అని ఉంటుంది, దాన్ని ఒకసారి ఫాలో అవ్వండి. అక్కడ ఇంటర్ప్రిటేషన్ అని ఉంటుంది, ఇంటర్ప్రిటేషన్ మీకు తెలియకపోతే మీ కోచ్ని అడగండి, వాళ్ళు గైడ్ చేస్తారు. సో ఇంటర్ప్రిటేషన్ అవైలబుల్ ఉంది తెలుగులో, హిందీలో, ఒకసారి చెక్ చేసుకోండి. ఇంగ్లీష్లో సార్ మాట్లాడతారు. సారీ సార్, ప్లీజ్ గో అహెడ్.
ఓకే సార్, ఐ యామ్ ఆడిబుల్?
పర్ఫెక్ట్ సార్, పర్ఫెక్ట్.
ఓకే, వెరీ గుడ్. సో డోంట్ లెట్ యువర్ పాస్ట్ డిటర్మిన్ యువర్ ఫ్యూచర్. What happened in the past is history. What is going to happen tomorrow is when you create history for yourself and your families and for the company and the country. The second method of setting a goal is to have a revenge goal. Somebody insulted you in the past and said, you are not capable of getting rich. You are not capable of expressing yourself fluently. You cannot do a training. You cannot do a presentation. And so you say, okay, I am going to teach that person a lesson. I'm going to get rich, I'm going to get a trainer, I'm going to speak English fluently. That is second method of setting a goal. Again, not a very good idea. So you don't have revenge goals because weak people focus on revenge. And every one of you on this call, over 150 people, you're strong people. Learn to forgive people who have insulted you in the past and ignore what they say. Prove them wrong by action. So the first goal is limitation goal, where you look at your weaknesses, forget it. Second is to take revenge on people. Don't set a goal because you want to revenge on people. Set a goal because you aspire to become great. Set a goal which is aspirational, where you are not looking at past, you are looking at the future. And you have to have a very strong why in your mind when you set a goal. Why I wanted to do goal setting today was because when I started Herbalife, I didn't know why I was doing it, honestly. I started as a customer. Lavina encouraged me to use the product. I got onto the product. I got a result. People asked, and that is why we got into the business. We were under the mistaken impression that we were rich. And today I know we are not rich, because once you see Rajuji and when you see other 30Ks like him, you realize what really rich is. So I encourage you today to be aspirational upwards. Think of the future. Think of what you would like it to be and start goal setting based on aspiration. Because aspiration may not seem real to you today, but it is a true possibility. Every single one of you, 153 people on the call, can become president teams just from Andhra Pradesh. Because imagine 3 crore people and imagine 10% of them drinking a shake for breakfast every day. Just one shake, 2 volume points every day. In 3 crore people, imagine the strength of this. Even if it is not 3 crore, it is 30 lakh, 10% of the population. Imagine you will be doing 60 lakh volumes every day. You will end up doing 60 into 30 volumes every month. And a president team needs only 2 lakh 100,000 volume points. So we are looking at 10% of Telangana population having just one shake a day, and you creating over 600 president teams out of one single state. The good news is you can do this business all over. You don't have to be stuck to one state or one city or one country. So think of the future and aspire to grow. But many of us say, oh, I will be my president team. So Napoleon Hill says, no, don't think of a goal which has no deadline. Create a deadline for yourself and say, okay, I am going to do this by this time, which is what a goal is. It's a dream that you think of future, but you have fixed a time to it. And Anthony Robbins, who was the first among, he's worked 3 years with Jim Rohn as a student, said, once you start setting goals, you will start realizing them, because what seems invisible to you now will become visible for you. So learn to set goals. And the definition of a goal is, and towards which you are going to work, where you are going to make an effort. So I am on to tell you now, if you are going to today, after the training, write your own goal sheet, understand it will involve work. It is not a dream that you will think and it will happen. You will have to work for it. You will have to create an effort. You will have to learn. You will have to work. And effort is a must. Now, let's spend 1 minute telling you how you should learn to set your goals. Because till 40 years, nobody had told me that I should have goals. What was happening was good, but could tomorrow be better? I didn't know, because nobody had told me. every one of this on this call, your 178 people as of now should learn to set goals. And please write, your goal is should not be abstract, it should be specific. So your specific goal, for example, can be, I want to lose 5 kg weight. Don't say I want to lose weight. I want to gain muscle. Don't say I want to gain 1 muscle. Say I want to gain 3 kg muscle. And when you measure it, it becomes quantified. Whatever is measurable can be said you have achieved success or not. Many of you want to become president teams. I hope all of you want to become president teams. But if you think you are going to do that in 1 month, 3 months or 6 months, I think most of you will be disappointed. It's not so easy. It should be relevant to your current situation. You cannot say I will be a trainer for America when you cannot speak English. You have to learn English to speak. I want to train one day in Telugu. For that, I have to learn to speak Telugu, but I can only do that training for people who understand Telugu. It is no point me doing the training in Telugu for people in Punjab. And time bound means I have to decide whether I want to learn Telugu in 3 months, 6 months, 3 years, 2 years, 15 years or never. So all of you should write, your goals should be specific. You should be able to measure them. They should be achievable in your mind and in work physically. They should be relevant to what you are doing correctly. And you have to have a time frame. Make sure that they are time bound. Jim Rohn, probably among the world's foremost business philosopher on goal setting. In fact, if you go and look at trainings, and Rajuji is gracious in sending us a video every day of Jim Rohn, he always says, don't worry about what you're going to get today. Just imagine the value you will bring to the marketplace tomorrow, day after, next year, next decade. So if you set a goal and you achieve it, you will become better. You will become more. You will succeed farther than you think you can. And if you don't have long-term goals, you will always focus as, oh, I couldn't do this. Today I couldn't get up because I was not feeling well. I talked to 2 people today and they did not listen to me. When you have long-term goals, which are based on 1 year, 1 decade, or a lifetime, you will overcome the small obstructions that occur on the way. I told you in the beginning, and I'm repeating this, create a strong why for your doing Herbalife business. How is easy. Rajuji will tell you how to do it if you tell him what you want. If you don't know what you want, what can you do? Alice in Wonderland said a very good thing. She said, if you don't know where to go, any path will take you there. But if you want to come to Delhi, you cannot go towards Chennai. You have to come towards north. If you don't, it doesn't matter to you where you go. You can go north, you can go east, you can go south, you can go west. What does Herbalife give you? And all of you on this call, including me, all 200 of us, can choose to have health by using the product, can choose to develop an income and become wealthy by doing the business. We can be happy because we have helped somebody become better today. The amount of recognition Herbalife gives you is tremendous. You have parties, you have friendships, you have vacations. And of course, as you grow older and you don't want to work hard, you will still have royalties and residual income. And many people, and Rajuji is young as far as I'm concerned, he can retire today and have a fun life. You look at your own president teams, Rajesh Upala, he can retire today even when he's just 30 and live a very, very, very good life because he has worked hard in Herbalife so far. You decide today on this call, do you want health, wealth, or all of it? And everything that is on the screen, you can get if you work hard. Now, when you joined Herbalife, it was on the spur of a moment. Lavlina and I looked at an engineer talk about health and nutrition, and we started using the product. That was a spur of the moment decision. That was not a decision that was designed to get us to president teams. That was just a decision to try a product. And many of you on the call today, 205 people, very good now, will also look back and say, oh, why are we doing Herbalife? Why do we need to work hard? Why do we need to come to trainings? Why do we need to come to meetings? And I will give you the answer for that as we go along. First thing, life is about thinking positive. Are we having negatives in life? Yes. This training I could have been doing with you in Hyderabad in an auditorium, but I am doing it in my office and you are in your own homes. The positive thing is there is still information going down. I am learning from you, you are learning from me. I could also think, oh, if I was in an auditorium, it would be better, and forget it, it's not going to happen. So all life, you will have a choice between negative and positive. Think positive, think positive, think positive. Today, when you talk to somebody, he should look at you and say, I'm looking at this person and find he's just positive about everything. So jokingly, I tell people when somebody comes to me, or oh, doctor, I have fractured a leg. I say, thank God you fractured one leg. You could have fractured both. So be grateful that only one leg is fractured. You can still limp on the normal leg. That is why you should think positive. Now, when we write our goals today, and I will encourage all of you, and I'm sure Rajuji will join me in this, Cynthia ji will join me in this, that you should have written goals. So think, why did you join Herbalife? You may have joined as a customer like I did, but you can graduate to do business and become a president team once you decide. If you are happy using the product at a discount, just stuck to being what is called a discounted customer, now called privileged customer. If you want to do a little business, get a little 5,000, 10,000, 20,000 income, just produce a little volume every month. But if you want to go to the top, you have to learn to be a business builder. How much in the terms of health? How much fat would you like to lose? How much muscle would you like to gain? What sort of a skin would you like? What sort of energy would you like? How much income would you like? It is not saying, oh, I want to make money. You have to know how much money in how much time. Because if you are not putting a when to it, then it is very logical. I know many of you on this call are associates today. And I am happy that you have decided to do a little business. But is that the position where you want to be for life? If you don't want, and if you want to build a business, you have no option but to upgrade yourself to a supervisor. If you have decided today that you want to ultimately end up at a president team, you need to become supervisor this month. It is no point becoming supervisor in September 2022 and hoping you will become president team in December 2022. It is not going to happen. But if you become a supervisor this month, there are tremendously bright chances that if you don't become a president team in 12 months, you will at least become a mill team. If you don't become a mill team, you will at least become a get team. So you have to decide today in your own mind and on paper, what position would you like to be? Would you like to continue to be associates? Would you like to upgrade to a success builder or a fully qualified producer or a supervisor? Each one of us on this call has to take his or her own decision. For example, I'm sure you know Rajuji is doing very, very well in business, but he wants to be 30K and 40K. He has to understand that it has to change. I am president team. I want to be 15K. I know I have to change. So you have to decide yourself what position you would like to be. And it is not because we don't want to get rich. It is because we are not willing to put the effort to get rich. So Vince Lombardi, one of the most famous business philosophers and sports coach, said, people fail because of lack of commitment. So if you think you want to become rich and you're not willing to work for it, it is just a dream. It's not going to happen. Commit yourself today. Commit once more today to set up a goal that you want to achieve. Lot of people we see use Herbalife shake for a month and let go. They have 40 kgs to lose and they want to do it in a month. They are just trying. It is like a marriage. You cannot get a marriage when you say to your potential father-in-law, let me stay with your daughter. 4 or 5 months, we will stay together and we will see if the marriage works. If it works, we will marry. Otherwise, we will separate. Do you think that's going to happen? At least in India, it is not going to happen. Every business, every life decision you take has to be based on 100% commitment. It cannot be try. If it works, great. If it doesn't work, no problem. You have to be locked to Herbalife. You have to marry Herbalife for life before you can become really successful. So Jim Rohn taught us this, and I am going to share his wisdom to you, because like I tell you, if one thing you lack in Herbalife today is you did not get the opportunity to meet Mr. Jim Rohn, see into his eyes and learn from him. We were lucky, Rajuji was lucky. A lot of people on this call may have actually seen a live training with Jim Rohn, but when he's not here, his tapes are here, his books are here, his sayings are here, his videos are here. Just look them. సో జిమ్ బ్రౌన్ సేస్ డిసైడ్ వాట్ యు వాంట్ దెన్ లెర్న్ టు సెపరేట్ ఇంపార్టెంట్ థింగ్స్ ఫ్రమ్ ఇర్రెలెవెంట్ థింగ్స్ అండ్ వెన్ యు ఆర్ నాట్ డూయింగ్ వెల్ లెర్న్ టు మోటివేట్ యువర్ సెల్ఫ్ అండ్ యాజ్ సూన్ యాజ్ యు స్టార్ట్ అచీవింగ్ గోల్స్ కాంగ్రాచులేట్ యువర్ సెల్ఫ్ డెవలప్ అ సెల్ఫ్ కాన్ఫిడెన్స్ దట్ యు విల్ రీచ్ ద అల్టిమేట్ గోల్ ఫస్ట్ write a goal in a positive manner. Don't say, oh, I wish I will become, I you could become rich. Say, I will become rich. Then say, to me, being rich is when my bank balance at the end of the year is 20 lakh rupees. I will work in developing a customer base and develop an associate base because that is the most important for me. Not going to watch the James Bond movie because it is available at 12 o'clock on a Thursday in free of charge. If you don't write goals, you will never ever achieve them. And please understand, sure you want to become president team, but first upgrade yourself to supervisor if you're not one. From supervisor, go to becoming an active supervisor. Then become a world team. Then become a GATT team. Then become a GATT 2500. Before you can become president team. So keep the goals small, keep the goals achievable, and base them on performance. Don't think president team is a person who does 200,000 organization volume. Think president team is a person who has 2,000 customers in his first three lines. And you cannot develop 2,000 customers in first three lines without having the first one. So the realistic goal is, let me first have 25 first line MRP customers myself. Then I will teach somebody else, who will teach somebody else, who will teach somebody else. And one fine day, all of us will be doing 2,500 volume point based on MRP customers. And when 80 people do that, I will become president team. When you write goals, split them up. What check would you like this month? How much retail profit would you like this month? If you are a supervisor, decide today, upfront, when you will become an active supervisor, which means 3 months of 2,500 volume point. When you will become world team, which means either 10,000 in a month, 5,000 in 2 months, or 2,500 4 months in a row. How is your health? Are you happy when you get up in the morning with your health? Or would you like to become better? We will do trainings the whole day for you. You will have to decide, would you like to attend all the trainings? Would you like to attend some training? Or would you like to attend no training at all? Because in democracy, you have a choice. You don't want to attend the training? Don't. You want to start on the training halfway through? Or you want to be there before the training actually starts? You decide. Now, the basic function of money is to give you comforts in life. You have to understand, if you want to celebrate your son's birthday, are you going to do it at home? Are you going to take them to a small restaurant? Are you going to take them to the most expensive five-star hotel in your town? What would you like to buy? A new home, a new car, a new mobile phone, a new watch? And if you do not progress as a person, all the money in the world is useless. So you will have to focus 15 minutes, 20 minutes, 30 minutes every day in the morning, reading books, listening to CDs, or on your mobile phone, the YouTube videos, which make you feel better, which develop the human being in us, which give us the confidence that whatever we do is worth doing. If you do not choose goals that are worthwhile, nobody will appreciate it. If you do not have goals that are achievable section by section by section, you cannot run a 10-kilometer race in 1 minute. You have to do the first kilometer, then complete the second kilometer, then complete the third kilometer. When you look at a triathlon, you have to first swim, then you have to cycle, then you have to run before you can complete the goals. And like I told you, if your goals are not specific, they are just dreams. And every time, I strongly suggest every one of you on the call today to tell your family what your goals are. Tell your sponsor, I listened to a training on goal setting and I am going to be X in this time. And when my December check comes, it will be this figure. And I will explain to you what happens when you fail. Tell everybody you know, I will become president team in Herbalife. Can you do it tonight? No. Can you do it ultimately? Yes. If everybody knows that you are focused on getting wealthy, healthy, becoming the president team in Herbalife, nobody can stop you. Obviously, every day in the morning, you have to choose between going out to the market, buying vegetables and ration, which is important because if your family doesn't eat, it's a problem. But when you have to choose between upgrading your skills and listening to a tape or going and sitting and reading a newspaper, I strongly suggest forget the newspaper. It is only negative news. Listen to a tape. When your goals are real to you, when you can sit in an office and smell your car or smell the perfume you are wearing or see the pen you are writing with, they will become real to you. And every time you achieve a goal, reward yourself. Say, well done, Anil Nadir, you did a great job today. Now, please understand, in the next 5-7 minutes, I am going to tell you how to do the goal setting, which means what you should do and what you should not do. The first thing, create a plan, but don't wait for it to come around automatically. If you draw a plan, you will have to do it. Don't wait for, I will become president team someday. I will get a 1 lakh check someday. I will get a better health someday. That is not going to work. Decide now when you want a 1 lakh check. Decide now when you want to become president team. Decide when you want to be drug-free, disease-free, and lead a life that most people dream of. Second thing, think in small terms. You cannot expect an associate to become a supervisor tonight. Is this possible? Yes. Is it desirable? Yes. Is it possible for everybody? No. So think, I am an associate today. Let me upgrade to a senior consultant. Let me try this month to go from being at 25% discount to 35 or 42% discount. And if you start worrying about 42%, 50% president team, royalty, bonus, you will become totally confused. Don't mix up everything. Don't make a khichdi of your business. Go step by step. It's like making food. You don't add everything together and hope for a good dish. If you look at a chef make a dish, he first, for example, fries the mutton before he fries the onions and the tomatoes, or he fries the onions and tomatoes before he fries the meat. He's not going to put everything in, put all the spices in, and hope a great dish will come. You don't make a biryani just by adding everything together. You go step by step by step. If food can be made in steps, in small steps, so can Herbalife business be. Write it down. And every time you write a goal, in the bracket, write a time. For example, in my practice, when a credit card bill comes, they send a notice 15-20 days back. So in my diary, I write payment of credit card, I write the amount, and in the bracket, I write the last date. Because if I don't know the last date, then when will I pay the bill? Similarly, when you set up a goal for yourself today, after the call, after the training in the evening, give yourself a deadline. Just don't write a goal and say, kabhi bhi hoega to dekhenge. That is not going to happen. Be specific. Herbalife is specific. Formula 1 comes in 8 flavors. It comes in 8 flavors. It's not Formula 1 will come in about a dozen flavors. When a multivitamin box carries 90 tablets, it carries 90. It doesn't carry 89. It doesn't carry 91. If you're abstract about life, you won't reach anywhere. Goals have to be specific, exact. And please don't expect to succeed every time. Everybody fails in spite of trying their best. It is human nature to be imperfect. You will be a god if you are perfect. So please don't beat yourself up when you fail, when you try. Important thing is not the result. Important thing is the try. If you try, you are likely to succeed. If you fail, fail forwards. This is a very important concept which I want to explain to you this time, because most people think of life as failure and success, which is not true. Most life successes are failing forwards. If you look at Nobel Prize winners this year in medicine, for example, or physiology, their research is 30 years old. They researched in 30 years back before they got a Nobel Prize. Now, if you look at Luis Ignaro, he won the Nobel Prize in 1998, but his research started in 1974. Imagine 1974, 75, 76, 84, 85, 86, 94, 95, 96, and in 98, he won the Nobel Prize. Learn to fail forwards. If you today write a goal of, I want to make 1 lakh rupee check, well, last month you had made only 10,000 and you fail. But be sure that you will not make 10,000, you might make 50,000, or you might make 60,000. So you can sit back and say, oh, I failed in my goal of 1 lakh. No, you made progress because 10 became 50. So learn to fail forwards. Backward failing, bad idea. Not failing, impossible. Nobody is successful all the time. We fail in life because that's human nature. But if you fail forwards, one fine day, you will get that 1 lakh check because from 10,000, you became to 50, from 50 to 60, 60 to 70. Similarly, weight loss. Some people lose 2 kgs first month, lose nothing in the next 2 months and they get disappointed. No, be happy that you lost 2 kgs in the first month. Be happy that your energy is becoming better every day. You're sleeping better. Your digestion is better. Your hair is better. Your skin is better. Of course, we would like you to lose all the weight tonight, but that is not going to happen. So write down, I will fail, but I will fail forwards. I will not fail backwards. When you are successful, celebrate. Jim Rohn always used to say, mourn for one day and celebrate for one day. So tonight, when you listen to this call, when you tell your sponsor, I am a success builder today, but I will be a supervisor this month. And you become a supervisor. Take him out for coffee and say, see, sir or ma'am, I achieved the supervisor level. I would like to reward myself and you for my success. Just because you couldn't become supervisor this month doesn't mean, oh, this business is not for me. I am depressed. I will not get up. I will not work. I will not talk to people about product. Don't beat yourself up. Human behavior is failing, failing, failing. Success is in me, not without me. What is the point of somebody becoming president team when you are not there on the stage yourself? So success comes from within you, not from without you. Karen Raven said a very good thing. I wanted to you to write this down. Only as high as I can reach, can you grow. You cannot touch a tree 30 feet high unless you're yourself 30 feet tall. If you're 6 feet tall, you can touch anything 6 feet. But imagine a 4-year-old child trying to touch a shelf that is 6 feet high. It is not going to happen. If you do not look for success, you can never get success. So if you dream, you can become. If you don't dream, you can never become. So I'm encouraging you to dream big because then tomorrow we will teach you to work big. Learn to dream big. And Yiddish proverb comes from Israel, says, man plans and God laughs. So sure, many times we set up goals and we fail. Because ultimately, whether you like it or not, it is all Almighty. That is why he is called Almighty. You and I are not called Almighty. We are not Almighty. Our job is to work hard, set up goals, and try and reach them. Katha Upanishada is a dialogue with death. And it is one of the best things you can ever read if you are inclined to spiritually reading. Is Swami Chinmayanand's exposition on Katha. It says, you are what you desire. As you desire, you will. As you will, you will act. As you act, you will get it. It's your destiny. So if you desire to become president team, you will start thinking that I will do no matter what it takes for me to develop an organization of president team. If you have decided to become president team, from tonight, your actions will change. Your clothes will change. Your watches will change. Your hairstyle will change. Your thinking will change. And because you change your thinking, your destiny will change and you will become president teams, which is why it is so important to desire before you will, to act after you have willed, and that action will take you to your destiny. And so I want to thank you, the 35 minutes that I wanted to spend are over. goal setting can be 100 hours and still less. But today I wanted to give a brief idea of what goal setting should be about. Lovlina and I would like to join you in thanking you for your time, effort, patience, and hopefully every one of you today will write down your goals. You will be smart about your goals. You will be realistic about your goals, and you will declare your goals publicly. Tell everybody you know, one fine day, within the next 2 years, next 3 years, next 5 years, I'm to be president team. By the way, it's interesting. When you look at president team, you're looking at a person that decided on day one that this is where I want to be. Some people take 9 months to become president team. Some people take 3 years. Lovlina and I took 13. And I know many people who have been with us from Herbalife from day one and 21 years down the line, they are not president teams. But I know in my own downlines, the mill teams make over 6 to 7 lakh rupees per month. Forget the bonus they pick. So please understand, if they are going to be frustrated about being in Herbalife for 21 years or not president team, they will never appreciate the 7 lakhs they make every single month. You should learn to appreciate what you have from Herbalife. And this is the time for you to start asking questions. I am here to hopefully answer your doubts. Think about goals. Any question you have about goal setting, please ask me.